Welcome once again, dear friends, to another edition of Fresh Bread. This is Reverend Phil Anderson here of Oakland United Methodist Church and Kansas Avenue United Methodist Church here in Topeka, Kansas. So glad to have you with us here on Holy Week. It is now Holy Wednesday. This is the week, again, that we remember Jesus going to the cross for our sins. It's known as Holy Week. It's a very important week for most Christians, I believe, as we remember those final days of Jesus Christ, how he went all the way to the cross for our sins. You know, he could have turned back at any time, but he went all the way knowing what awaited him at that cross, which was going to be the most unbelievably excruciating death, not just physically, but the spiritual component, where Jesus now, who lived a perfect life, fully God, completely holy, completely righteous, completely pure, takes all of the sins of the world upon himself as that great act of sacrifice because of the love that God had shown to the people that he created who had turned their backs on him. Well, you know, Jesus had people that turned their back on him as well, yet he didn't let that deter him. He still went all the way to the cross. So today, let's look at this devotional from Henry Nouwen from the booklet called Steadfast Love. This is for Wednesday of Holy Week. And we read from John chapter 6, verse 51, "I am the living bread that came down from heaven. Whoever eats of this bread will live forever." Jesus died for us so that we may live. He poured out his blood for us so that we may find new life. He gave himself away for us so that we can live in community. He became for us food and drink so that we can be fed for everlasting life. Henry Nouwen writes, "Toward the end of the week that changed the world forever, Jesus prepared the food and drink that enable us to live in communion with him and with each other. In the upper room, he prepared a feast that offers forgiveness and new life for us and all believers. Jesus continues to offer his body and blood anew to us each time we gather to celebrate Holy Communion with our community of believers. In this sacred meal, he not only strengthens and equips us for daily service in his kingdom, but also feeds us for eternal life. On the cross, Jesus then became food and drink for us, pouring out his blood as a payment for our sins and the means by which he earned eternal life for us. These powerful gospel assurances motivate and empower us to go forth each day to share his spiritual and physical food and drink with as many people as possible." And then this prayer, "Living bread from heaven, feed us for everlasting life with the bread of life, and inspire us to share your forever food with those who hunger and thirst for righteousness. Amen." It's hard not to think about our own personal connection with Christ this week. Almost as if we pull back from others so that we recognize it's our sins, my personal sins, that put Jesus on the cross. And yet we can do that in the context of the greater community of believers, not just here in Topeka or in Kansas or the United States, but around the whole world. Christ came for everyone, regardless of nationality, religious upbringing, regardless of ethnicity or race, gender, income status, social status, educational status. You know, we like to categorize people, don't we, in our lives. I think that Christ is the great equalizer in all of that. We all stand on level ground at the foot of the cross. Heard a song on the radio the other day. It said, "There is no line at the cross. We're all there together at the same time, at the same place. Jesus died for each and every one of us." You see, we've all sinned and fallen short of the glory of God, and that's why Christ came. Don't lose sight of that here during Holy Week. It's easy to just get caught up in trying to figure out what do we need to do for Holy Week and put this pressure on ourselves. I don't think God wants that. I think he wants us just to remember him. But he wants us to do that every day, not just during Holy Week. You know, my prayer is that we take whatever we have gotten out of Lent and Holy Week as we're nearing Easter now, and that we would carry that with us into the rest of the year. This can be the catalyst for us to move forward with Christ. It's a day-by-day experience. I was listening to someone just yesterday. I believe he was on the Eternal Word television network. It's a Catholic channel. And the gentleman said something that I just caught a little bit of what he was talking about. And I thought he really had a great insight there. And he said, we should have a conversion experience every day. I like that. I can receive that as something that I believe will be a good challenge to think about here, especially as we near the end of Holy Week. This conversion, if it was a daily thing, just think we would be renewed every day. For a lot of us, we kind of look back in time and we think that our experience with Christ dates way back many years ago, and that we had that experience, but now it's all just sort of stagnant and it's just stationary and nothing has changed. And matter of fact, we may have even slipped a little bit, but I don't believe that needs to be the case. I think every day should be fresh and new and exciting, knowing what Christ has done for us, knowing that he is alive inside of us, and that we're not commemorating some type of a historical event here during Holy Week and just looking at things in the past, but realizing that because of what Christ did and this particular excruciating experience that he went through for the love of you and for the love of me, we now have this great new life that he has given us. We have truly been born again, and we now can go forth and live in a way that we wouldn't have been possible for us to live otherwise, because now it's not only us who's living, but it's Christ who lives in us, and it's the Holy Spirit who's giving us the power to live the life the way that God wanted us to live it when he created us. So that's my prayer during Holy Week, is that we won't just make this a special week, but that we would make it a special time in our life, that we would now allow this to blossom and grow and to make us more fully committed to Christ all the way through, so that now we will live our lives as unto the Lord. Galatians 2:20, I have been crucified with Christ. The life I now live, I don't live in the body anymore, but I live by faith in the Son of God who loved me and gave himself for me. Can we all allow Christ to come in and just take over our whole lives, physically, mentally, spiritually, emotionally, relationally? How our lives would be different if we did. We would all find that great fulfillment in Christ that he wants us to have. I pray that this will be a week that isn't just segregated out and we don't ever think about it again until next year when Lent rolls around, but that this would be something that would be a life-changing experience for you and for me, to bring us into a new level of relationship with Christ. Well, friends, thank you again for joining me today. I do wish you a great Holy Wednesday, and we'll see you back tomorrow for Maundy Thursday. Until then, may God richly bless you, is my prayer. Have a great day.